Hulu's new Books of Blood is an ambitious and frustrating film. As a Clive Barker fan, it's frustrating to find out that a new adaptation of one of his works is coming. Then you hear more about it, and it feels like those behind it might as well have made a story on its own and left Clive out of it. Books of Blood adapts a few morsels of Clive Barker's The Books of Blood story, and then fills the rest of its runtime with other stories. Welcome back to M.L. Miller Frights, a part of the Kings of Horror Network. I'm M.L. Miller. While you might be watching this video on the Kings of Horror Network, I urge you to click over to my M.L. Miller Frights page and give it a like, share with your buddies across the electronic superhighway, subscribe to this channel, and don't forget to ring that bell for notifications. Please get the word out to new folks so we can make the Kings of Horror Network, as well as M.L. Miller Frights, bigger and better. If you're in the Chicago area and love horror, you have no excuse not to head over to the Chi-Town Movies Drive-In for the Music Box of Horrors. Every day in October for 31 nights of horror, there will be late shows Sunday through Thursday and double features every Friday and Saturday night. Every weekend is themed: Grindhouse Fridays, Rip-Off Saturdays, and Sequel Sundays. Tonight they're playing a double Grindhouse feature of the director's cut of Clive Barker's Nightbreed and Death by Temptation. Look below for a link to the schedule where you can get tickets and directions to this awesome horror event. Books of Blood was just released new streaming on Hulu. It was directed by Brandon Braga, and it's written by Adam Simon, Brandon Braga, and adapts the story of The Book of Blood by Clive Barker. The film consists of three stories, sort of. I say that because stories have a beginning, middle, and end, and instead of offering up that, the stories are made to connect with one another. So one story abruptly ends, then another begins, only for the prior story to come back and come to some kind of semi-conclusion. I've read where the filmmakers were trying to make this film a horror equivalent to Pulp Fiction, but I think even mentioning Pulp Fiction and Books of Blood in the same sentence is pretty offensive. Books of Blood opens clumsily with a tough guy named Bennett, played by Yul Vasquez, who is tracking down a guy named Bookman, who owns a bookshop. After getting some info about the location of a rare and priceless book, Bennett kills the bookman and heads out to get the book for one last score. Meanwhile, we flit over to an illustrious glass house on the ocean and meet Jenna, played by Britt Robertson, a troubled girl who has misophonia, an abhorrence of sound. When she hears her mother and father plan to drop her off at The Farm, which is a psych facility that Jenna has stayed at before, she steals some cash and takes off. Leaving her meds behind, Jenna begins to doubt her own senses when she sees someone following her and takes refuge in an Airbnb. After this tale plays out almost to its fullest, we jet over to a posh mansion where a psychologist, Mary, played by Anna Friel, meets Simon, Rafi Garon, a man who claims he can talk to the dead. Having just lost her son to cancer, Mary is reluctant to believe Simon, but when he is able to show her proof of his power, she believes in him, forms a relationship with him, and centers her work on his power. Finally, when this installment plays out, we reconvene with Bennett, who we met at the beginning, as he tracks down the Book of Blood and what it means to finally find it. Now, you'll recognize aspects of Clive Barker's work in The Books of Blood, but what is adapted is so unrecognizable that if Barker's name wasn't on it, I doubt you'd be able to make the connection. Gone are most of Barker's purple prose, describing the pathways between the flesh and another hellish dimension. Gone are the rich characterizations of the players involved. Everything is simply boiled down to basics in order to fit within a 20-minute story. But while most short stories would work with that much time, Barker's concepts are usually a little bit more complicated than that, which is why most of his short stories have been adapted into feature-length films, and why those only scratch the surface of the worlds Barker creates. I will give it to this film. I like the original story focusing on Jenna the best. It would have made for an interesting episode for a series, but there's a character turn at the end that simply makes no sense and pretty much ruins the entire story for me. There's some pretty gnarly effects, a lot of bugs. And I like the sense of unease actress Britt Robertson and director Brandon Braga were able to convey in this section of the film. There really is a palpable sense of paranoia through this tale, but the installment misfires twofold. Once, when it cuts away anticlimactically just before the segment comes to a close to move on to another story, and then when they return to that story towards the end when Jenna's character takes an abrupt turn. The second story, focusing on Mary and the ghost whisperer Simon, is a little bit more faithful to Barker's story, but the focus on the eroticism between Friel and Gavron felt off, like something you'd see in a Red Shoe Diaries episode. The late in the game leap into gore is sudden and effective. Fans of the short story know what I mean, but it felt too little and a little too late. The final story, focusing on Bennett, who we meet at the beginning, feels less like a story and more like filler, as Bennett has no real motivation. There's no real conflict and no real reason for his final fate, rather than a few glimpses at Bennett killing people. It barely qualifies as a third part to this film and really doesn't make for a potent way to wrap things up. Maybe my distaste for Books of Blood would have been less so had the films not been connected to Clive Barker. On its own, it has its moments of tension, gore, and pathos, but Books of Blood is not going into the archives as one of Barker's greatest adaptations by a long shot. That'll be it for today. If you like this video, please pound that thumbs up button. Share this video with your social media addicted pals. If you're looking for written reviews and the Best in Horror Countdown 2020, you can find them on mlmillerwrites.com. Don't forget, I have two new horror comic book trade paperbacks you should look for. Grave Trances is out right now in all comic shops, and Pirouette, collecting never-before-published issues, will be out in late November, early December. Diamond order code APR 201712. And be sure to subscribe to this channel and ring that bell for alerts to be the first to see my future videos. Thank you so much for your time, and take care. Stuck inside your reality, you're doomed. Oh, you're doomed. You're doomed. Live the life that you are meant to be. Live inside that you are.